For this screen analysis, I decided to focus on the 2008 film The Hurt Locker, directed by Kathryn Bigelow. The subject area that I want to specifically discuss about this film is the realism of war depicted by it. The Hurt Locker contains great visual effects along with strong performances by the actors, but the thing that stands out the most to me is the realism that Kathryn Bigelow shows throughout. She tackles issues such as PTSD, intensity during a battle, fending off steam when away from the battlefield, and family life struggles. Unlike many other war films, this one is a non-glorifying picture that is not intended to promote the triumphs of an individual person or group. Instead, it focuses on how certain people cope or mentally handle the stressful environments that they are in. So this scene is a good representation of the type of mindset that the EOD squad leader, William James, has while disarming bombs. So I'll play this for you real quick. It's just a minute clip.
What's he doing?
I don't know. What are you doing?
There's enough bang in there to send us all to Jesus. I'm gonna die.
After the trunk of the car is opened, it was revealed how much explosives he is dealing with. Rather than regrouping with his team to discuss another approach and handling it, he decides to continue and try to disarm it. At this point, his safety gear, as he stated, is useless and would rather die comfortable than in a suit. It's a gritty and chaotic shot that shows the stressful condition that the team is in. While James seems to be rather cool and collected during that whole take, his partners Sanborn and Eldridge are not as calm. But these personas are quite different, but seems to be very fitting that the roles that they need to play in the team, as Sanborn and Eldridge are there to be pretty much his protection, watch out, while James focuses on the bomb itself. So if this next slide turns. Here we go. Okay, so behind the scenes of war, scenes such as this one show how the lives after battlefield are shows how the soldiers kind of live, behind the scenes when they're not on the battlefield, where they find a way to vent and let off steam. So play this one real quick. Alright, so unlike other war films where, when they're not in the battle scenes, they're depicted as, cleaning their guns or sharpening their knives when they're off, not actually fighting, Kathryn Bigelow decides to show that these are characters are men and women just like the audience who need to always, mentally get away for a bit, get off the mindset of being in war. It is a fitting shot in the story because of the message Bigelow is trying to make. Even while they are off patrol and back in their barracks, the mentality of being in war cannot completely be forgotten. It starts off as a typical guys being guys type of scene with drinking and competition, but in the end it still depicts that they cannot truly escape. However, as shown with the knife being brought out by Anthony Mackie's character. One too many. There we go. Okay. I feel that this following scene is one of the best and most meaningful of the film. After all the explosive and intense shot, the audience had seen that James had been going that James had been going through, we now find him back in this state with his family. The now mundane and routine lifestyle of cleaning out rain gutters and shopping in the grocery store is really wearing on him. Even now being back safe with his family, he misses that rush of the EOD job. Simple tasks such as picking out a cereal is an unfamiliar territory for James, and he appears more uncomfortable doing this than disarming an explosive device. Now we go to the last slide. So those are three clips that kind of, you know, are very quite different, very from each other quite a bit, but it helps kind of tell the story that Kathryn Bigelow was trying to make. Overall, I found out that she did a great job with the film, The Hurt Locker, and that it's not just another war film. Instead, it dives deeper into the healthy or in the reality of what soldiers are going through on a daily basis overseas and while back at home. Having a great storyline and screenplay, along with stunning visual and sound effects, made this one of my personal favorite films I've ever seen.